ओके, क्लिक ऑन ओके। टुडे कॉन्सेप्ट टू रिफ्लेक्शन एपीआई।
I can't see your screen still.
टुडे कॉन्सेप्ट रिफ्लेक्शन एपीआई।
Forty-5 minutes.
ओके ओके, कान ओके, क्लिक कान ओके। राइट, टुडे कॉन्सेप्ट नेम इज रिफ्लेक्शन एपीआई। टुडे कॉन्सेप्ट नेम इज रिफ्लेक्शन एपीआई। एपीआई एपीआई मीन्स एप्लीकेशन प्रोग्रामिंग इंटरफेस। Reflection API. API means Application Programming Interface. Application Programming Interface. API contains some predefined methods or functions. Some predefined methods, predefined classes or predefined classes. API contains some predefined classes. Among them, one of the class method class, among them one of the class method class. What is the use of method class? Method class reference can hold any other method. Method class reference can hold any other method in the specified class using same reference we can invoke that method. So API contains some predefined classes. Among them, one of the class method class, very very important class, method class. What is the use of method class? Method class reference can hold any other method in the specified class. Using same reference we can invoke that method. So what is the method class we will discuss? Up to now we discussed only about non-static. Okay, if you want to call the non-static function from same class, or if you want to call the non-static function from another class, we need to create the object. So today concept is how to call the static function from another class, or we can say simple, or this is my own definition, using method class reference. We can call the static function from another class. We can call the static function from another class. Using method class reference, we can call static function from another class. How to call the static function from another class using this method class, we will discuss today. Go to SRC, take the new class API. And taking one class API, only I am taking class API. Click on finish. Here I am writing one function, public static void login. SYSO control space login. This is the function I wrote. Save. Right. Take another class. Go to SRC. Take the new class. The class name is Reflection API. Ref. Keep the mark public static void when you click on finish. I wrote static function API. I want to call that function. If it is non-static, we need to create the object here and we can call that function. If it is non-static, we can create the object and we can call that function. But that function is static. How to call the static function from another class? So, store in one string. It should be cap. String is equal to, that function name is login. That function name is login. So I want to call that function. So now method m equal to previous class name API dot class dot get method. Get method s. S means string reference. So m dot same reference invoke m dot invoke m dot invoke m. M dot invoke m. Add throws declaration. So after writing the code, it will show you some exceptions. No such method exception, security exception, add throws declaration, illegal access exception, illegal argument exception, invocation target exception. So these are the exceptions we need to add. So we need to add all the exceptions. We need to add all the exceptions. No such method exception, security exception, illegal access exception, illegal argument exception, invocation target exception. So these are the exceptions in Java. So these are the exceptions in Java. So here I am storing string s equal to login. Previous class function is login. So method that reference is m equal to previous class name is API dot class dot get method s. S means string reference. So here after writing this class, after writing this code, it will show you throws, it will show you underlines. That means we need to add exceptions. How many exceptions we need to add here? 5 exceptions. Keep the cursor on underline. Automatically we can get add throws declaration. So no such method exception 1, security exception 2, and still it is showing underline. Keep the cursor, add throws declaration, illegal access exception, illegal argument exception, invocation target exception. So these are the exceptions in Java. So already previously we discussed IO exception and the file not found exception. IO exception, file not found exception. Last class we got 2 exceptions. One is IO exception and the file not found exception. But here we have 5 exceptions. These are the Java exceptions. In Java, 7 exceptions we have. One is IO exception, second file not found exception, and no such method exception, security exception, illegal access exception, illegal argument exception, invocation target exception. So whenever you are facing the interview, that time they may ask you like how many exceptions available in Java. So we have number of exceptions in Java. Entire Java, we have number of exceptions. But in our portion, we can get only 7 exceptions. 7 exceptions. So tell me some exceptions. That time we should tell IO exception, file not found exception, no such method exception, security exception, illegal access exception, illegal argument exception, invocation target exception. Okay, this is the method class used. Sir, this class is very big. So is there any other alternate? Yes, we have other alternate. It is very mass. So if you want to call the static function from another class, so previous class name is API. API dot function name is login. So directly we can call. No need of this method class. No need of any method class. Without this line, directly simply previous class name dot function name. Previous class name, function name. Directly we can call.
So what is the advantage, sir, using these 3 lines? Why are we using these 3 lines?
So this is we want to use method class. Method class. If you want to implement method class, if you want to work with method class, so then we should store in one string that function name. We should store in one string, and we can using method class reference we can call that function. That is another concept. That is the one concept. But here this is the mass. This is the mass class name. That function name. This is the mass. So. What if you want implement method class compulsory we should write the three lines there, or otherwise directly if you want call the function from another class, if you want call the static function from another class, if you want call the static function from another class, then simply we can write class name dot function name, class name dot function name. Okay sir.
Okay,
simple concept sir. So using method class reference we can call the static function from another class, we can call the static function from another class. So or otherwise API class name dot function name, API is class name dot function name is login, class name dot function name. So we can use this both, we can use this both anyone. But if you want to implement method class compulsory we should write the three lines, we should write the three lines. Okay. Okay, concept is over. Right, next concept. If you click on run, whatever you wrote, that logic we can print here. It will print here. So in the API, login Rajendra Garu. Login Rajendra Garu. Save. If I click run. So it will print login Rajendra Garu. So it is calling or not? Yes, login Rajendra Garu. So I don't want use method class now. So delete it, uncomment it, save, click on run. Login Rajendra Garu. Got it, sir?
Yeah.
Right. Next concept. Next concept, overriding. Next concept to overriding. What is overriding? If at all a function existing in parent class or one class. If at all a function existing in parent class or one class, if at all a function existing in parent class, then that function, if we write in child class, if at all a function existing in parent class, then that function, if we write in child class, then that concept is, overriding. If at all a function existing in one class, then that function if we write in another class, then that concept is called overriding. If at all a function existing in one class, then that function if we write in another class, then that concept is called overriding. Or if at all a function existing in one parent class, then that function if we write in child class, then that concept is overriding. Here concept is whatever we have in parent class function should be there in child class. Whatever we have in parent class function should be there in child class. If you want extra functions, you can write in child class. But that parent class function should be there in child class. That is the concept of overriding. So in child class, if you want to write extra function, you can write it, sir. But that parent class function should be there. That parent class function should be there. Then only we can say that concept is called overriding. If at all a function existing in parent class, then that function, if we write in child class, then that concept is called overriding. So that concept we will discuss now. Now go to SRC. Take the new class. Class name is I am taking model one. First I am taking, so this is the parent class. Just treat as a parent class. Model one. I am taking one class. So here I am writing functions. Public void. I am writing call function. Call function I am writing SYSO control space call model one call So I'm writing here three functions. Model one call, model one reject. Model one reject. Model one message. Model one message. Right. I'm taking one class. In that class, I'm writing three functions. Call, reject, message. Three functions I'm writing. Save. Right. I'm taking another class. Here I wrote only three functions. Call, reject, and message. I'm going to SRC. Once again, I'm taking class SRC. Take the new class model 2. So here also only I'm taking class. Here I'm writing three functions. Model 2 call, model 2 message, model 2 reject. And here I'm writing extra function also. Here I'm writing extra function also. So public void WhatsApp. Model 2 model 2 WhatsApp. Right. So in model 1 I wrote three functions. In model 2 also I am writing four functions. Not only the three functions, I am writing extra function. Already I told you. So whatever we have in parent class function should be there in child class. In child class, if you want extra function, you can write it. Here I am writing WhatsApp extra function I am writing. Okay, right. Now go to once again SRC. Take the new class. The class name is over. Keep the mark public static void main, click on finish. Now I want to call the function from this main method. So then how to call the function from main method? All are non-static. If it is all are non-static, we need to create the object. Model 1, M1,
M
equal new,
equal to
new model
new
1.
Model 1.
M1 dot call. M1 dot reject. M1 dot message. Next, I want to call the model 2 functions. Model 2.
M2.
M2 equal to
new model 2.
New model 2. M2 dot call. M2 dot message. M2 dot reject. M2 dot WhatsApp. So right. So this is the overriding concept. If at all a function existing in parent class, then that function, if we write in child class, then that concept is called overriding concept. So next concept to interface. Next concept to interface. What is interface? Interface is something created between two somethings. Simply we can say, what is interface? Interface is something. Very, very important concept. Based on this concept only, we can enter into Selenium tomorrow. Interface is something created between two somethings. Created between two somethings. Interface is something created between two somethings. Interface is something created between two somethings. In between two something, I'm keeping something. In between two something, I'm keeping something. So that is called interface. Interface is something created between two somethings. Interface is something created between two somethings. In between two something, I'm keeping something. So that is called interface. Interface is something created between two somethings. Okay. So for example, iPhone people, they want to maintain some common features in each and every model. Finally, they decided they want to maintain some common features in each and every model. So in iPhone, we have different models like 3SU, 4SU, 5SU, 6SU, 7SU, 8SU. Like we have different models. They want to maintain some common features in each and every model. That's the reason they are creating one interface So they want to maintain some common features in each and every model. That's the reason they are creating one interface and they are keeping the functions. They are keeping the functions. Just for example, they want to maintain call, reject, and message. These three functions they want to maintain commonly in each and every model. That is the reason they are keeping an interface. If they want to introduce any model into market, first of all, they will install this interface first of all. After that, if they want any extra functions, they can add it. But each and every model should contain this interface functions. Each and every model should contain this interface functions. Each and every model should contain this interface functions. If at all any interface function missing, automatically it will show error. Automatically it will show error. So each and every model having this interface functions are not, so we need to check. How to check? So we will discuss now. So first we need to create the interface. How to create the interface? Right click on src. Remember sir, so right click on src, same. How to create the class? Just take the interface. And taking interface name is iPhone. For example, I'm taking interface name is iPhone. So in this iPhone, they want to maintain some common functions in each and every model, or functions or features, both are same. So they want to maintain some common functions in each and every model. Public void call, it is a common function they want to maintain in each and every model. So public void reject. So this is also they want to maintain commonly in each and every model. And public void message, they want to maintain these three functions in each and every model. That's the reason they are keeping an interface. If they want to introduce any model into market, first of all they will install this interface. So first of all they will install this interface first of all. If they want extra function, they can add it. If it is new model, we need to add some extra functions, so they can add it. But each and every model should contain this interface functions. Now I'm going to model one. So what is the main difference between call function and interface function? What is the main difference between class function and interface function? Class function having function body, interface function don't have any function body. This is the main difference, sir. So class function having function body, interface function don't have any function body. 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 So now go to model one. Model one having these interface functions are not, I want to check.
Yes.
If it is three functions, then manually we can check it. So each and every phone, iPhone having thousands of functions. So manually we can't check. So then I'm writing implements. Model one implements iPhone. Right. Save. So if it is any function missing, for example, I'm deleting. Control X. It is showing error. Why? Because so that interface function missing in model one. So that's the reason it is showing error. So control V. So it will not show any error. Okay. Model one having interface functions. I'm going to model two. Here also I want to check model two having interface functions or not. Implements iPhone. Here also we have interface function. Here also we have interface function. Extra function, we can write it. So there is no objection. But interface function should be there in each and every model. Yes, here also it is not showing an error. Why? Because whatever we have in interface functions having in model 2. Okay, right. Save it. Now we will learn only one line. Only this line purpose we learn Java, sir. This line purpose we learn Java. That is interface name. Reference name equal to new class name. Interface iPhone. I equal to new model one class name. New model one. So now through interface reference, I want to call the functions. I.call we can get. I.message we can get. Why? Because we have an interface. I.reject we can get. Right. Next, I want to call iPhone.
Model 2.
iPhone I1 equal to, change the reference frame, sir. Model 2. I1 dot call. I1 dot message. I1 dot reject. I1 dot WhatsApp, we can get or not?
Yes.
No. Why? Because there is no, in the interface, there is no WhatsApp function.
In the interface, it's not there.
Yes. So, through class reference, we can call the all class functions, but interface reference, we can call only interface functions only. Okay. Using interface reference, we can call the only interface functions only. What we learn from Java, only one line, sir, only that line purpose we learn Java, that is interface name, reference name equal to new class name. Using this class, using this sentence, we can enter into Selenium. Tomorrow we can enter into Selenium, sir. Save, click on that. What we learn from Java, sir?
Interface name.
Interface name, reference name equal to?
Interface name, reference name is equal to new class name.
Okay. This line, just remember, sir, tomorrow morning, once again, I will ask you, just you should remember, reference name equal to new class name. Interface name, reference name equal to new class name. If you know this only one line, more than enough. You can learn Selenium very comfortably. Even fourth class kid also, you can learn Selenium very comfortably. But you should know only one line, that is interface name, reference name equal to new class name. Interface name, reference name equal to new class name. Right. Save. So, this is the concept, sir. This is the today's session. So, only in Java, we have only one pending concept, that is detailed Java, just arrays concept we have. So, that arrays concept I will teach you later, no need. So, using this sentence, we can enter into Selenium. Okay?
Okay.
Yes, practice it, sir. Tomorrow we have class, same time, India time, 11:30. Okay? Have a nice day. Take care, sir.
Sir, malli ikkada ee Java ippudu language complete ka depth ga raavala sir etla
no need whatever, just if you know only this line, more than enough, sir. Whatever we learned, this is more than enough for Selenium.
Okay,
so there is no relation between Java and Selenium, sir. Frankly, this is already record session is already started, recording it is filed. After this class I will keep in YouTube. So there is no relation between Java and Selenium. Whatever we learned in Java, that logic we will use in Selenium. So the Selenium script is totally different. Okay, it is no relation between Java and Selenium. Why we are learning Java? Logic purpose. That logic indirectly we will use in Selenium. That is the reason we learn Java.
Okay.
Okay.
Sir. And also please give, sir, I installed the Quality Center in XP system that's still not working.